Good morning, my dear students. We are back with our physics lecture. We have started the lesson electric current and its effect. Am I right? We have in the last video we have discussed about the symbols. Am I right? Symbols, the different electric components, how we can use, and if you want to represent the electric circuit, particular electric circuit on the paper, then we have to use the symbols. Am I right? In today's video, we are going to start heating effect of electric current. In the last video, in the concluding part, I have told you if you will see the bulb, yes or no, if you will see the bulb, if it will keep for a longer period of the time, and after some times if you will touch that bulb, you will find that the bulb is little bit warm or the hot. Why it is so? Because of the heating effect of the electric current. So what is exactly heating effect of electric current? See, actually the electric effect, electric current and its effects are of mainly three types: heating effect, magnetic effect and chemical effects. In the class 7th, we are going to discuss this heating effect and magnetic effect in a detail. So first we will see the heating effect of the electric current. Okay, so what is heating effect of electric current? See, when an electric current pass through the high resistance wire, the electric energy is converted into heat energy. Electric energy is converted into heat energy, which heats up the resistance wire. This is called as a heating effect of the electric current. So what does it means? See, in your book there is one activity is given. So in that they have placed two nails are there. Then for that we have to use one thermocol, one wire which consists of nichrome wire, the two nails, then one wire which consists of nichrome wire, we have to tie a nichrome wire. For this support we will use a thermocol. To fit this nail, we will use a thermocol, and this connection will be given for the switch. In a switch, you can use a pin. This is a switch. Then, after switch, what we think we need? Sail. Sail is very important. We need a sail, and this connection is to be done. Okay. This is a complete connection. When the switch will be on for some times, as the current will flow, this is a nichrome wire. What is the full form? Means actually what it consists of, that we will see first. It consists of iron, nickel, chromium and magnesium. Are you getting? So as the current will pass through this circuit, this wire will get heated. Why? In this case, the electric energy, here electric energy is passing, that will be converted into heat energy so that it will get heated. Are you getting? So this effect is called as a heating effect of a current. In this case, actually what is happening? The electrical energy is converted into heat energy. So where we can use this heating effect of electric current? There are the different applications or where we can use in everyday life, we use this heating effect of electric current. So there are some electric heating appliances. For example, you might have seen the electric iron. You might have also seen the heater, electric heater, oven. They all works on the principle of the heating effect of the electric current. What actually happens? See, if you will take the electric iron, okay, In that, there is one wire which consists of nichrome wire, which consists of very high resistance wire, which is called as the heating element, That wire, actually, it consists of nichrome wire. Nichrome, I have told you, what actually it consists of iron, nickel, chromium, and magnesium, which is of very high resistance. As the electric current will pass through it, it will become hot. This wire will become red hot, and which will be used for electric iron. What is the use of the electric iron? It is used for the ironing the cloth, then heater, room heater, which is used to warm the room, and electric then the electric heater is which is used for cooking the food. So these are the applications where we can use the heating effect of electric current. Are you getting this? Then the next uses of electric bulb. Now in the class 6 we have already discussed about the electric bulb. Electric bulb consists of one filament, a thin filament, which is called as, do you remember what is the name of that filament? Yes, it is called as a tungsten. Yes, it consists of a tungsten, a thin filament which consists of tungsten. As the electric current pass through it, the filaments become very hot. It becomes a little bit red hot, and it start to generate a light and also heat. It starts to emit the light and also produces the heat, which is based on the principle of heating effect of electric current. But if you will see the bulb, it actually waste a lot of and lot of electricity. It is a wastage of electricity. Instead of that, now we are using the CFL. Yes or no? Instead of this, we are using the CFL. Now, can you tell me what is the full form of CFL? Compact fluorescent lamp. Now, if you will see, these are the CFL. CFL is nothing but compact fluorescent lamp. Are you getting what? Instead of why we are using the CFL bulb? Because it minimizes the wastage of electricity. Are you getting? Electric bulb use a lot amount of electric energy. Here there is a lot of wastage of electricity. So instead of that, we are using the CFL. CFL, what is the use of the CFL? It does not work on the principle of the heating effect of electricity. It does not have any kind of filament. Are you getting? So what is the full form of CFL? Compact fluorescent lamp. What is the full form of CFL? Compact fluorescent the lamp. Are you getting? And the one more advantage of the CFL is that it can be used the holder. Now if you will see the bulb holder, you might have seen this bulb holder, am I right? It can be fitted in the bulb holder also. Are you getting? So this is one advantage of the CFL. Are you getting? One first advantage is that it can minimize the wastage of the electricity. Second, it can be used in the bulb holder. Are you getting? It can be fitted in the bulb holder. Nowadays we have started to use the LEDs. Instead of this, we have started using the LED. Can you tell me what is the full form of LED? Light emitting diode. What is the full form of LED? Light emitting diode. Are you getting? Now, whenever we have to buy the electric appliances, we have to see one mark, that is ISI mark. We have to see the ISI mark. So, can you just tell me what will be the full form of ISI? ISI stands for Indian Standard Institute. We have to check ISI mark. What is the use of this ISI mark? It tells that it can use the less amount of electricity, it can consume the less amount of electricity, and the whichever the component which we are using or which we are buying, which we are going to buy the electric appliances, it is of good quality. Are you getting? It consists of the ISI mark. It is observed. It tells us that it can consume the less amount of electricity. And second thing is that the electric instrument which we are buying, it consists of good quality. Are you getting? So ISI mark is very important. So whenever we are buying any electric appliances, you have to check the ISI mark. ISI, what is the full form of ISI? Indian Standard Institute. Are you getting? So these are some applications of the electric effect of the electric current. One more application of the electric effect of electric current is that electric fuse, which works on the principle of heating effect of electric current. Electric fuse, you might have seen, now every household has an electric fuse. You might have seen the electric fuse. If you have not seen, just go and you can see the electric fuse, but don't touch anywhere, just see the fuse. Now if you will see the electric fuse, it consists of like this. See, this is the electric fuse. What is actually the working of electric fuse? When the excess amount or the large amount of the current is flown, when the excess or the large amount of the current is used, it breaks down the flow of the electric current. When we are using the excess amount of electricity, if you will see the fuse, it consists of two. Here there is one wire, here there is a wire, here there is a wire which consists of thin copper, which consists of thin copper. Electric fuse consists of this thin wire, copper wire, which consists of thin copper wire, which has a very low melting point, which has a very low melting point. Okay. Then what happens when excess current flows through this wire, when household appliances gets an excess current, when the excess current flows through the household electric appliances, then as it gets heated, it melts down and break the circuit. This will break the circuit, and as the circuit will break, it will stop all the electric current, and it can also damage all other electric appliances which are there in our household. It can also cause the fire. So when the excess current flows through it, what happens actually in the electric fuse? This is a wire which consists of copper wire, thin copper wire. When the excess current flows to the household chores, at that time this wire melts and break the electric circuit, and sometimes it can cause the damage to the other electric appliances which we are using in our household. Are you getting? It can also cause the fire. Are you getting? So now instead of this electric appliance, this electric fuse, we can use the MCB. MCB. Now what is the full form of MCB? So what is actually the MCB? See, this is the MCB. MCB is nothing but miniature circuit breaker. What is the full form of MCB? Miniature circuit breaker. What is the use of this? When the excess current flows through it, it automatically breaks down the current. And it stops the current to flow from it. Are you getting? When we are using the excess amount of current, when we are using the excess amount of current, what happens? It automatically shuts down. It automatically see, there is, if you will see the MCB carefully, there are the buttons. If it is up, then it can be on. And if when the excess current will flows down, it will automatically shut down the current. So it can prevent the damage for the electric appliances, or it can also prevent the damage for the causing the fire. Are you getting? So it can prevent our electric appliances. Are you getting? So instead of the electric fuse, nowadays we are using the MCB, which can be, if suppose excess amount of the current is flow through the circuit, then it automatically turns off the circuit. Electric stops the electric current to flow from it. Or we can automatically on this circuit. Are you getting? So we can use the electricity. But once the fuse will get damaged, we have to replace it. Once the fuse will get damaged, we have to replace it. Are you getting? So instead of this electric fuse, nowadays we are using the MCB. What is the full form of MCB? Miniature circuit breaker. Circuit breaker itself, the name itself tells us, if the excess amount of the current will flow through them through the circuit, it will automatically will break down the circuit. It will automatically turn off the electric circuit. Are you getting? So nowadays we are using this type of fuse, or we can say this type of miniature circuit breaker. Are you getting? I hope you all have understood it. Today's work is that you have to read the points which I have taught you, and just recall all the full forms which I have shown you. See, in today's video we have learned the different types of full form, that is MCB. What is the full form of MCB? ISI, LED, CFL. So these are the different full forms which we have seen. So go through it, read the lesson, and remove the difficult words from the book, and write in your physics notebook. Thank you.